अगत्तिक गति नत्वा हीनार्थाधिक साधकम् श्री चैतन्यं लिखते अस्य प्रेम भक्ति वदानता। तो श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु, दिस इज द प्लेस ऑफ श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु, अपियरेंस साइट ऑफ श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु, श्रीधाम महापुर। सो इन दिस प्लेस दिस इज एप्रोप्रिएट लिटरेचर, श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत। वी मे ट्राई टू डिस्कस ड्यूरिंग दिस holy days. Last year, some gentlemen suggested, after seeing my all literatures, that you kindly write the translation of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. He thought that this business I can do very nicely. So I took the initiation from this gentleman and began to write. Now it is almost complete. I am now translating Madhya Leela, 20th chapter, the discussion, Sanatana Shikha. So it is estimated that 10 volumes like this. You think like that? 10 volumes like this, that will complete Chaitanya Charitamrita. Chaitanya Charitamrita is the postgraduate study of Krishna consciousness. The Bhagavad Gita is the ABCD to entrance, and Srimad Bhagavatam is the graduate study, and Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita is the postgraduate study of spiritual life. My Guru Maharaj, His Divine Grace Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, whenever he got some time, he used to read Chaitanya Charitamrita, and he predicted that the whole world like to read Chaitanya Charitamrita, and for this reason they'll learn Bengali. Therefore, following his footsteps, I have kept the Bengali character and try to give the literary meaning of each word of the Bengali poem. This is, of course, Sanskrit. This book is full of Sanskrit verses. Some of them are composed by the author himself, Kaviraj Goswami, and some of them are quoted from various literature, Vedic literature. So, the author is accepting Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu agatika gati. Agati. Agati means, gati means movement. And gati means also destination. So, agati. At the present moment, especially in this age of Kali, people are not moving. Moving means we are moving. This moving is not very good. Moving means material movement. Not that we are not moving, but we are moving. But agati. We do not know what is the destination of the movement in this age. The trees are not moving, but we are moving. But that movement has not very much improved our condition. Real movement means to go forward, to reach the Supreme Personality of God. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Nate vidu sartha gatiṁ. Sartha gatiṁ. This gatiṁ again. As it is said, gatiṁ. The same word is used in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Sarthagati. Why one should move? Unless one knows the destination, the goal of life, why one should move forward? So, at the present moment, they are moving, but they do not know which side they should move. That is the defect of this age, Kali Yuga. Mandya sumandha mataya sumandha matayo mandha bhagya jubadhuta. Because they are moving, but not very rapidly. The real purpose of movement is hathagating Vishnu, that they do not know. They do not know. The materialistic world at the present moment, that they do not know where the movement should terminate, where is the destination, that they do not know. Nate sarthagating Vishnu, nate vidu. Not only in this age, that is the state of material life. Those who are passing in materialistic way of life, they are thinking that sense gratification is the ultimate goal of life. Indya prita, nunam pramatta kurute vikarma, jat indya prita aprinoti. Nunam pramatta, they have become mad. Pramatta. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. Movement means we are doing something. Not inactive, just like stone. But what kinds of activities we are doing? Because we are madness. We are mad after sense gratification. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. Vikarma means things which we should not do. Karma means prescribed duties. And vikarma means actions which are not prescribed, whimsical, simply for sense gratification. That is called vikarma. Karma, vikarma, akarma. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. So, nunam pramatta kurute vikarma. Why? Jat indriya pritaye aprinoti. Indriya pritaye means for satisfaction of the sense. In the Kali Yuga, for satisfaction of the senses, one can do anything, horrible thing, abominable thing. That is called rascal now. They do not know what to do. So, Rishabdev says, this is not good. You simply for sense gratification, you are acting so whimsically, as you like, as you please. This process of activities or gati is not good. Na sadhu manne, Rishabdev says, it is not good. Why it is not good? Jata, because you just try to understand, you have got this body on account of your past misdeeds. This body, this material body, these rascals, they do not know. They think that if I get a body of a king or a rich man, that is my success. But that is not success, because you may get a king's body or very exalted body, this life, but you have to change this body. That is, you will be forced. Suppose you are very in exalted position, you are minister or king or something, but you will not be allowed to stay. But these foolish persons, they do not know. They do not try to understand that what is my next position. Therefore they are called mad. Nunam pramatta kurute. Mad man doing. He does not know what is the ultimate goal, because they do not know that there is life after death. Tathadehantara prapti. They do not know that. Therefore they are mad after this sense gratification. Therefore Rishabdev says that nasadhu manne. He was instructing his sons, my dear boys, this kind of life, irresponsible life, to do anything and everything for sense gratification is not very good. Why? Because you are creating another body. You have already got experience of this body. It is full of miseries. Adhyatmik, adhibhauvik, adhibhautik. Three kinds of miserable condition of life. Beyond that, there is ultimate miseries, janma mitya jara vyadhi dukkha doshana darshana. But they are so rascals, they do not know how death taking place, what is after death, what is mitya, what is death, what is birth, what is disease, whether they can be cured, whether one can be free from all these troubles, they do not bother. Therefore, in this age it is said that prayena alpa ayusha kalau asmin juge jana mandya samanda matayu mandabhaga jivadrita. Especially in this age, people are mandabhagya, unfortunate. We have got so much assets to know from the Vedic literature, but they are so unfortunate, they do not take advantage. They do not take advantage. Manda, 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 slow, and mandabhagya, manda sumanda mata. They'll read so many bogus literature to waste their time, but they will not take to the Vedic literature. Even the simple book, Bhagavad Gita, wherein everything is very nicely described, how we should lead our life, how we should utilize the benefit of human life, everything is described there. But they are manda. They will take interpretation of a rascal of Bhagavad Gita. Sumanda matayo. Even they read Bhagavad Gita, they will read some rascaldom. Sumanda matayo. The Mahavadi philosophy, they will take it. Not Krishna's philosophy. They are reading Bhagavad Gita, Krishna's book, but interpreting in the Mahavadi way. Therefore, Sumanda matayo. Their intelligence is very bad. Manda samanda matayo, manda bhagya. The unfortunate. In India, there are so many Vedic literatures, full of treasure house of transcendental knowledge. But mandabhagya, they will read Lenin's literature. You see? How much unfortunate they have become. As if Lenin can speak more than Krishna. This is going on. Not only here, everywhere, all the parts of the world. There are mandabhagya. Mandyasa mandamatayo mandabhagya. Jupadruta, at the same time they are disturbed by so many conditions, just like at the present moment, there is no rice, no wheat, no food, the agitation, mandabhaga, upadruta, upadruta. They must be disturbed, because they have not taken the right path. Therefore, it is concluded here by the author, agateka agatingatva. If we take the path of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then we are embarrassed in so many ways. We can get the light. We can get the light. We can reform our life. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teaching is so nice. Of course, the great author Kaviraj Goswami has depicted the activities and teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and this Mahaprabhu is the birth site of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. 500 years, 488 years ago, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu traveled on this street. Now, still, that memory is going to be revived by this Krishna consciousness movement all over the world, because Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted this. Prithivite ache jato nagura adigra, sarvatra prachar hoive varra. So, his prediction is coming to be true. His prediction is coming to be true. Now, you European and American, African and Australian, so many, all parts of the world you have come. This is due to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's desire. He wanted it. Prithivite ache jato nagara adigram. He wanted to be famous, to become famous, and people should thank him. He wanted that. He told them that when they will know my philosophy, that is the desire of Sri Chaitanya, they will thank me. And actually, you are already thanking him by getting the sublime instruction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction? It is the same instruction as Krishna gave. Krishna wanted sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam braja. That is Krishna's mission. Because it is the duty of the living entity, because they are part and parcel of Krishna, it is the duty of everyone to abide by the orders of Krishna. That is the duty. Jive sarupai nityak, this is the instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna wanted that you should all surrender unto Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that your real constitutional position is eternal servitude of Krishna. There is no difference between Krishna's instruction and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction. Because he is Krishna. There Rupa Goswami said, Namo Mahavadarnaya, Krishna Prema Pradayate. Krishna Prema Pradayate. Here it also said, Vadarnata, Prema Bhakti Vadarnata. Vadarnata. Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Vadarna means most magnanimous. People could not understand Krishna, although he advised personally in the Bhagavad Gita that sarvadharman parityajyamamekam. They are so rascal. Abhijananti magamurha manasim tanumasita. They thought that Krishna is ordinary person, maybe little learned or little powerful. But they did not take up Krishna as the supreme personality of Godhead. Even big authors, scholars, they cannot understand. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his Krishna himself, came again to teach us Krishna consciousness for our benefit. Therefore, his Mahavadarnabhata. So if we want to understand Krishna, we must try to understand Krishna through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then it will be very easy to understand. Other people, they do not try to understand Krishna through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They try to understand Krishna directly. Therefore, they fail to understand. Manushyanam sahasre sukasche jatati siddhaye jatatam api siddhyanam. So Krishna cannot be understood by ordinary way. Krishna can be understood only through one way, not many ways. What is that one way? Bhaktyamam avijanati javanjaschami tat. Only bhakti. So that bhakti, yet it is said, prema bhakti badarnata. This Chaitanya Charitamrita, Vrindavanam, and as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught us personally, going to Vrindavan and asking his disciple, Rupa Sanatana, to exhibit it and manifest the glories of Vrindavan. So in Vrindavan, the Goswamis constructed temples. The present city is due to these Goswamis, or Sri Chaitanya, present city of Vrindavan, or present importance of Vrindavan is due to Sri Chaitanya, otherwise people forgot it. It was lying vacant, a big tract of land only. But this Gaudiya Vaishnava, initiated by Sri Rupa Goswami, therefore Narottamdas Thakur says, Rupa Raghunatha Pade Haive Akuti Kave Hama Bujhava Se Jugala Piriti. Vrindavan means Radha Krishna's activities, pastime. So that is the destiny of life. That is the real goal. As Sri Chaitanya Narottamdas Thakur says, that Manasya Janama Paiya Radha Krishna Nabhojiya Janiya Suniya Visha Khaina. One who has got this human form of life, if he does not understand what is Radha Krishna, his life is spoiled. Janiya Suniya Visha Khaina. Knowingly, they are eating poison. Because by coming in contact with Radha and Krishna, they can go back to home, back to Godhead. And there will be no more Janma Mitya Jarabhyadi. Such opportunity is human life. Simply to understand Radha Krishna. And therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Mahavadarnabhata because he is teaching about the love of Radha Krishna and teaching everyone Krishna Prema Pradayate, real destination of life, how to achieve Krishna Prema. And he is personally teaching Namo Mahavadarnabhata. Rupa Goswami understood it. There is Namo Mahavadarnava, most magnanimous incarnation. Similarly, Lochandas Thakur has sung, Parama Koruna Pahudui Jana Nitai Gaura Chandra Sabha Avatara Sara Shiramani Kevala Ananda Kanda. Kevala Ananda Kanda. Parama Koruna. There are many incarnations. But no better incarnation, no magnanimous incarnation like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda Prabhu is always ব্রজেন্দ্রনন্দন যেই শচীসুত হইল সেই বলরাম হইল নিতাই। নিতাই গৌর মিন শ্রী চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু ওয়াজ ফর্মালি কৃষ্ণ, হিজ কৃষ্ণ স্টিল, জাস্ট ফর আওয়ার আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং। As we think that I had my former life, actually I had, but that former life is finished. I am now a new life. But in case of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, it is not like that. It is simultaneously existing. Krishna is also existing and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also existing. The example is given in this connection. Just like the sun, now it is not visible. In India, the sun, but other part, in America, it is visible. So sun is there, but it is not visible at the present moment in India. Similarly, Krishna is there, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there, their pastimes are there, it is going on, but it is now not visible in this part of the universe. There are innumerable universes. So by rotation, Krishna or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes to a particular universe at a certain period. Just like the sun will rise again tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. Similarly, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Krishna and all his incarnations, they are rotating regularly. That is described in the Brahma Sanghita. Rama adi murti sukala niyamena tishtan নানাবতারমকরত ভুবনেষু কিন্তু কৃষ্ণ স্বয়ং সমভবত পরম পুমানজু গোবিন্দমাদি পুরুষম তমহং ভজামি। সো রাম নৃসিংহ বরাহ ইনিউমারেবল ইনকার্নেশন, দিস ইনকার্নেশন হ্যাভ বিন কম্পেয়ার্ড জাস্ট লাইক দি ফ্লো অফ ওয়েভস, ইফ ইউ সিট ডাউন অন দি রিভার সাইড অর অন দি ওশন সাইড, ইফ ইউ ওয়ান্ট টু কাউন্ট how many waves are there? It is impossible. They are coming regularly, day and night. That is not possible. Similarly, how many incarnations are there? It is impossible. For us, our knowledge is not so unlimited. Therefore, we cannot understand. So in this way, incarnations are coming. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the topmost incarnation. Parama Karuna Pahu Dui Jana Nitai Gaura Chandra সব অবতার সার শিরোমণি কেবল সব অবতার সার শির। দের আর মেনি ইনকার্নেশনস, বাট শ্রী চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু হি ইজ দি মোস্ট ম্যাগনানিমাস ইনকার্নেশন, বিকজ ইন আদার ইনকার্নেশন জাস্ট লাইক লর্ড রামচন্দ্র দি কলপ্রিট দি ক্রিমিনাল আর দি সিনফুল ডিমন রাবণ হি ওয়াজ কিল্ড, Krishna also, when he appeared, he killed so many demons. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, demons like Jagai and Madhai, did not kill them, but delivered them to become the best type of Vaishnava. This is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's incarnation magnanimity. What he will kill? These demons are petty demons. They can be killed only by slap. So, it is not very difficult to kill them, to call for Sudarshan Chakra or any deadly weapon. They are already killed. There is no food. How they will work? How they will fight? So it is not possible. So it is to kill the dead man. Now Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu incarnation, if they want to kill them, they are already dead. To give them life again is Krishna's or Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's special gift. Therefore he said, Sri Chaitanya prema bhakti badarnata, his magnanimity. He delivered by his personal example, Jagai Madhai. Jagai Madhai, they were born in nice Brahmin family, rich family, but they were drunkards and meat eaters and woman hunters. That is their fault. And for this purpose they can do anything and everything. They were doing that. So the whole world is now all drunkard and woman hunter and meat eater, especially in India, although it was unknown. Now the government is teaching how to drink wine, how to eat beef, and this is going on. So now the whole world is full of Jagai Madhais. That is a fact. Now by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they can be delivered. How they can be delivered? That is being instructed by the author, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, by personally behaving. Agati kagati natya hinartha adhika sadaka. Hinartha, those who are dispossessed of all good qualities. Hinartha. Artha, artha means possession, money. Artha, anartha and paramartha. The paramartha, there is no question of paramartha. Even they have no artha, ordinary riches. All poor men. You see in the street, not only here of course we are poor country, but in your country also, they are also hippies. Unnecessarily, they have become poor. Here, by circumstantially, they have become poor, like a wretched person loitering in the street. Now, while I was coming, and I was thinking that formerly, when we used to go through the street, we could see so many nice confectioners shop. But at the time, there's a tea shop. Tea shop and dry loaf, that's all. You cannot get any good food. No more kachori, singara, rasagulla. No, finished. All finished. Therefore, hinartha. Hinartha. They're very, very poor. They cannot, even there is such shop. Still there are some shops, like Dwarka, Darik Ghosh and Bhimna. But they can be taken advantage of a few people, a few richer section. But formerly, even a poor man could eat nice food from purchasing from the confectioner. But daily they are becoming poorer, poorer. Hina artha. Hina means devoid of artha, money. So, that is another qualification. Another qualification means those who are poorer, they can take to Krishna consciousness very easily. The richer section, they are very proud that we have got money. But in India, even richer section, they were devotees, and still they are devotees, but mostly people, they have become hinartha, without any money. So for them, this Krishna consciousness movement is very, very easy. Take advantage of it. Take advantage of it. Hinartha udhika sadhakam. Udhika means greater. Udhika sadhakam. Sri Chaitanya likhate yasya prema bhakti vadarnata. Therefore, see, Kaviraj Goswami is attempting to describe about the magnanimity of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birth site is there, and the annual 488th birth anniversary is going to be held on the 8th March. So, I am very glad. I welcome you from all countries. You have taken so much labor to come here. Take advantage of the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu described by the fittest author, Kaviraj Goswami, and we have tried to translate it as far as possible. Let us discuss. Thank you very much.